So guys, what is model? Model is nothing but it's a piece of reusable code that is sitting in a file which we can reuse across different parts of application based on our requirements and our needs. That's it guys, that is about model. Now there are three types of models. First one is custom models. These are the models which we create when we are developing an application. When we are writing code, we will create different files, right? Those are treated as custom models. Okay, and we have second type, which is called built-in models. Built-in models are the models which are provided by Node itself. So they come with Node.js installation, right? Example, we have something called FS model, which will help us to read or write file data on the hard disk. Okay, and we have one more type, that is third-party models or external models. So these are the models which are created by Node.js community or external developers. And we can use these models in our application using a package manager called npm. Examples are Express, Mongoose. Okay, so this is about model and these are the types of models. Now let's see what is this common JS models. Guys, before we talk about these common JS models, we all know what is ECMAScript standard, right? It's a standard or it's a set of agreed rules which will tell how a JavaScript should behave, what features it should have, right? And JavaScript is the implementation of ECMAScript standard. In the same way, Node is also having a common agreed set of rules or standard that is nothing but common JS models, which will tell how Node models should behave, how they should work. And Node will agree to this common JS models standard. Okay, that's it guys, simple. Like ECMAScript for JavaScript, common JS models is for Node. Okay, simple. Now I have one question, that is, what is the purpose of models? Why do we need models in our application? Why do we need to use models? So guys, to answer this question, I have few points. First point is, it will help developers to follow DRY principle in programming, which is don't repeat yourself. For example, let's say we have a function called add in our code and we want to use that function add across different parts. Now we are not repeating that code again and again, right? We are not writing the function again and again. Instead, we are putting that add function in a model and we are using that model, that piece of code, in different places, right? So that is how we are following this DRY principle. That is first point. Second point is, it helps to create structured code. That means we are not writing our entire application code in one file, right? Instead, we are dividing the code into different modules and we are following that modularity. We are following modules and we are putting pieces of code in that modules, which will help us to read, debug, understand more easily. And that is why the code will be more structured. Okay. And third point is code reusability, that we have already seen, that we already know. Okay. And fourth point is, same names don't override. This is important guys. So whenever we are creating a model and whenever we are putting a piece of code inside that model, that code from that model will not be exposed outside. The code will be private. Unless and until we explicitly expose it outside, the code will not be visible outside. It will be private, so that you can have different functions, different variables with same name in different modules. That means M1 can have something called grid and M2 can also have something called grid. Now these both are not, now this grid will not override this grid, because both are sitting in different modules, both are having a different scope and both are having different functionality, right? This is the beauty and this is the nature of models guys. Okay, now let's close this one and let's go back to page. And here I have few points. First one is, each file is treated as model, which we already know, and code is not accessible to other files by default, which we have discussed, and we should explicitly tell which parts of our code should be exported via an object called model.exports or exports, which we will see in some time. Okay, and here we have something called ES6 models. So point is, at that time JavaScript is not having any concept of modules or modularity in its in the language, but after ES 2015 version, JavaScript implemented, or JavaScript has its own standard model system in language itself, and Node is also implementing that, which we call it as ES6 models, right? We will talk about the differences between these common JS models and ES6 models in following videos. For now, let's just understand what models are. Okay, now let's go to VS Code and let's create a model. So for that, first let me open CMD, which is command prompt. I hope you guys have already installed Node. To check if it is installed or not, just type node -v, you will get the node version. Okay, now I'm gonna open D directory. I'm gonna create a folder in this, which is, let's say, mod 1, and I'm gonna open that one, cd mod 1, sorry, cd mod 1. Yeah, here I'm gonna open VS Code. So I'll write code, then space and dot. Yeah, let me close this one. Yeah, you can see, guys, I have created a folder mod 1. Now here I will create two files. First file I'll name it as m1.js, simple, and second file I'll name it as m2.js. okay, now let's come to m1.js. here let's create a variable. I'm gonna create a variable, let's say drink, because I just had a chai. So let's say variable cost drink equal to chai. I'm gonna close this one. Okay, let's save this one. Now I'm gonna go to m2. Here you can see nothing is there. Now let's print that chai here. So I'll write console.log. I'm gonna write drink here, and let's come out, let's save this one, and let's run this. To run this, I'm gonna open internal terminal, and I'm gonna write here node and file name. What is file name? m2.js. you see, it is saying drink is not defined. That is a concept, right? Because that code is sitting inside here, and that will not be exposed to outside by default, right? That is what happening here, and we need to explicitly make it available. So let's do that using a predefined function, sorry, using a predefined object which node will give us, which is available in node, that is module.exports. So let's do that. I'm gonna come here and I'm gonna type module.exports equal to, I'm gonna type drink. Okay, now we are making it available. We are exposing our variable drink. Whatever the content that is sitting inside will be visible to outside, whoever requiring this one, asking this one. Okay, I'm gonna save it. I'm gonna go to m2.js. now let's run this again. You see, it will still throw drink is not defined, because we are exposing it but we are not requiring it here. So to require something, we also have a predefined function in node, that is require. So for that, I'm gonna write here req require, and sorry guys, require, and here I'm gonna give, and this require will take string, and that string is the path of module, which module you wanna require. So we are in the same directory, right? Mod 1. I want m1, so I'm gonna give it one dot and then once forward slash. So it will search me. See, it is suggesting me m1. Now I'm gonna save it and I'm gonna run this m2 again. You see, still I'm getting drink is not defined. Why? Because, guys, I am exposing it here and I'm asking it here, I'm requiring it here. But it's like I am asking chai, but I'm not holding anything. I'm not asking, I'm just asking my chai with hands. I cannot drink chai with hands, right? I need to give a cup or saucer so that I can have chai in that, I can drink that. Okay, so for that, let's create a variable called cup. Okay, so I'm gonna come here, I'm gonna type const, let's say cup equal to require. So now what I'm telling is that I am asking that chai to give me in a cup, in this cup, in this variable, right, in my module. So now I'll change from drink to cup here. Okay, now I'm gonna click Ctrl S, save it. Now I'm gonna run it again. Yeah, you see, now it is printing chai. You got it, right? Concept, guys. First we are creating a variable here, drink, and we are assigning that drink variable to module.export, and we are requiring that using a new variable called cup, and we are working with that our variable cup here. Okay, so this is how we can create a variables, we can create data, and we can pass. Now let's do something. Let's go to m1.js, let's create a function. Okay, so I'm gonna type const greet equal to function, something called console.log. Hey, okay, now let's close this one, let's save it. Now instead of drink here, I will pass that function, I'll give that greet. You see, guys, here drink is a variable which is having chai. So I have assigned this drink to this model.exports, but this greet is a function expression. It's not a variable, it's a function expression, but still I'm able to assign that greet to this model.export. How is that happening? That is because of the nature of functions in JavaScript, guys. In JavaScript, functions are first class functions. That means you can treat functions just like you treat other types, that is number or string. So that means functions can be stored as a value in a variable, function can pass to another functions, functions can be put in arrays, etc. Okay, just like a recap, I want to tell that is how we are able to do this one here. Okay, now let me save this one. Let me go to m2.js. Here I'm gonna type, instead of cup I'm gonna type GRET, greet, and here also I'll remove this one and I'll call the function here. We need to call the function, right? So let me call the function. I'm gonna click on save and I'm gonna run m2.js. you can see now it printed hey. You see how it is working, you understood, right? First we are exporting something from this module and we are importing, that means we are requiring that using a variable, and we are calling that function using that variable. For better understanding, I've named it same, but we can write here greet2, or you can also put here greet2, and we can save it. I can come here, I can execute, it still print hey. Okay, I hope you got an idea about what are modules and why do we use them, guys. That's it for this video. In the next video, we're gonna talk about that difference between CommonJS modules and ES6 modules, and more about this require function and module.exports that we have here, right? All you have to do is just give it a like and click on that subscribe button so that it will motivate me to make more videos. Thank you guys, I'll see you in the next video.